I am a leasing agent, and this is my written leasing criteria. So I have everything in writing, just like your lawyer taught you to have, clear written leasing criteria. Over here, ball catcher. This is your application. So we are applicant by applicant. We'll let you go first, step up here. We're gonna see if this applicant can get her application through my leasing criteria, okay? So I want you to step back just a little bit, and all I want you to do is throw that ball through this hoop so we can see if she can lease at my property. Does she meet my criteria? Go through the hoop. Let's try it again. Well, we're filming, we'll edit that out. She can meet my leasing criteria, very good. Okay, so she just forgot to sign it or something, and then once she did, we sent it through the system and it worked just fine. Okay, well that was the easy, simple part of the skit, so let's see. Once you step back here, my applicant who meets my criteria. So now, thank you, now we have George Bush, okay? So we have George Bush. Why don't you take your application there, and we're gonna see if George Bush can make it through my criteria, so go ahead. Okay, that's good, he made it through the criteria, very nice. Yeah, you'll see, just to make sure he did, I kind of lowered it just a little bit to make sure he got through, but it was fine. He made it through. And now we have my last applicant. If you'll stand over there, thank you. We have Green Man. Would you step back here on the side, okay? And we're going to see if Green Man can make it through the criteria. Go ahead and hit it through. Oh, no, he missed my criteria. I'm so sorry, Green Man. So while I have my applicants up here, thank you. A round of applause for our ball girl. Thank you. So normal applicant made it through, and this teaching point is obvious. It's a green person. I know I've got my written criteria, but something in my gut. I'm trained in this industry, and I make good day-by-day judgment calls, and there was something, a judgment call I had to make, that green applicant is not someone we want. So for green applicant, I raised my criteria. And everybody knows that's a no-no. Because if I cause green applicant to not come in and to raise my criteria, he will say it's because he's Green Man, okay? That's one teaching point that most of you already know. But here's the real reason for this skit. Let me trade you with George Bush. Let's talk about my friend George Bush. As I told you, when George went through here, I had to help him just a little bit, okay? Help him just a little bit, because you see, technically, there was something in my leasing criteria that was gonna be a problem for George Bush. Because you see, George, well, he started a war. And that's a little bit of a technical problem under my written criteria. He started a war. But who wouldn't want George Bush on your property, right? Okay? Well, at least those of us who wear white shirts, red shoes, and black wingtips, like George Bush, okay? And who wouldn't want him here? So we want to kind of change our criteria a little bit, because my case-by-case judgment says we want somebody like this on our property. Well, that's a huge problem when you help someone in for some apparent good reason, because Green Man will say it's because this is not a green man and it's a white male who we're helping in. So how do you get through this problem? Because who wouldn't want a former president of the United States on your property? The key, the secret that allows you to follow the law and deal with those judgments. If your good judgment sense says, I want him in, he's the president of the United States, you change your criteria. Your criteria says, no felonies, no meth labs, and no wars having been started. And you change your criteria then to say, comma, unless you're a former president of the United States, okay? And then going forward, for every applicant, every other future former president of the United States, you have the written criteria and you follow it exactly the same. So when you have on scene, this is the play to win spirit I want you to have. When you say, Will Height taught me about consistency and putting it in writing and never making exceptions, but my good judgment here wants to change something to make an exception. Don't make the exception. Instead, say out loud, and preferably to someone else, what is it that I'm saying? Why am I wanting to make an exception? And it'll either cause you to say, well, that's pretty silly and pretty stupid and probably not a good idea, then don't make the exception. Or it'll make perfect sense on why there should be an exception to your written criteria. But then don't make an exception. Change the criteria so that the exception is now the rule, and that way no one can say it's not because he's a green man, and it's not just because of the color of this person's skin. It's because we like to have, consistent with our Platoan attitude, former presidents of the United States, so we change our criteria, and that's the way in criteria to play to win. Round of applause for our volunteers.